Good evening. My name is Mark Lysart, and it is my honour to welcome you this evening on the occasion of the Mass for the solemn dedication of Our Lady of the Southern Cross Catholic Church. The parish of Our Lady of the Southern Cross was inaugurated for Greater Springfield on the 25th of June 2011. Like that of Greater Springfield, the Catholic worshipping community has grown quickly under the pastoral leadership of parish priest Father Mauro Conti and the leadership team. In just 15 years, two Catholic schools, St. Augustine's College and Good Shepherd Primary School, along with Santa Care, the Mater Hospital and Mater Health Services, are just some signs of the tremendous growth and services that the Catholic Church now offer to the ever-growing Greater Springfield region. Tonight, the parish or church, its people, have a permanent and visible place of worship for all in Greater Springfield. For over 7 years, the parish community has gathered at the Augustine Centre at the generous commitment of St. Augustine's College. On a Saturday evening and Sunday morning, putting out and putting away over 500 chairs. This evening, I have the great pleasure of announcing that the chair committee is to be officially disbanded after the solemn dedication. In 2017, in the Archdiocese of Brisbane alone, we have solemnly dedicated two churches. And as you will see, there is a theme emerging. Stella Maris, Star of the Sea, and Maroochydore, and Mary, Mother of Mercy, Burley Heads. Tonight, we solemnly dedicate the third, Our Lady of the Southern Cross. And Mother Mary points to the constellation in the southern skies, also known as the Crux, or Latin, the Cross, directing us always to her Son, Jesus. This evening is a tremendous occasion, one that comes along for many of us only once in a lifetime. So welcome. Welcome to all guests, visitors, to the many people involved in making today a reality, to the parishioners of Our Lady of the Southern Cross. Particularly, I would like to welcome and acknowledge the presence of the Most Reverend Mark Coleridge, Archbishop of Brisbane, our principal celebrant for this evening, and all concelebrating priests that join His Grace and Father Mauro to solemnly dedicate and offer Mass here for the first time in this church, Our Lady of the Southern Cross. Could I now please ask you to stand as we acknowledge country and begin our Thanksgiving celebration. In line with Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander tradition, it is customary to acknowledge country as we pass through. Today we acknowledge and pay our respects to the First Peoples, traditional custodians of the lands and waterways, the Yagara people, and we thank them for their continued hospitality. We acknowledge and celebrate the continuation of a living culture that has a unique role in this region. We also acknowledge elders past and present, as well as our emerging leaders of tomorrow, and thank them for their wisdom and guidance as we walk in their footsteps.
Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live, a place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace, hear the love of Christ shall end dear visions. All are welcome, all
Peace of God be with all you in his holy church.
And with your spirit.
I invite everyone now to be seated for just a moment.
From the earth we have elevated a gracious space, where shadows become light, where straight lines become curves, and doubt will be reformed by the love and connection within this place. Joining now a long history in church design, this architecture utilizes sacred geometry, where heaven as a circle meets the earth as a square. Here in each curve, God's omniscience flows through the design from every direction, with heaven gloriously displayed as an interior sculpture in the dawn light from the east and as a long sunset from the west on the longest days of the year. The large praying hands which surround the church are pieces of the heavenly circle of life, where on entry and exit they are not only both part of heaven and part of the church, but also part of the community, as their sculptural presence quietly conveys the very special purpose of this place. This design was conceived especially for this community, a new community where Our Lady of the Southern Cross will be both a place of worship and a foundation for the diverse Catholic education and living within it. In its lines, architectural, musical and liturgical, we will make this church community stronger through our shared experiences here. It was a deeply moving experience to design this church, and our team has been humbled in steering this journey to this celebration in today's special ceremony. In grace and love, we now transfer this special charter to this church community. Amen.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, in this solemn rite of dedication, let's ask the Lord our God to bless this water created by his hand. It's a sign of our repentance, a reminder of our baptism, and a symbol of the cleansing of these walls and this altar. May the grace of God help us to remain faithful members of his church, open to the Spirit we have received. God God of mercy, you call every creature to the light of life and surround us with such great love that when we stray, you continually lead us back to Christ, our head. For you have established an inheritance of such mercy that those sinners who pass through water made sacred die with Christ and rise as restored members of his body and heirs of his eternal covenant. Bless this water. Sanctify it. As it's sprinkled upon us and throughout this church, make it a sign of the saving waters of baptism by which we become one in Christ, the temple of your Spirit. May all here today and all those in days to come who celebrate your mysteries in this church be united at last in the holy city of your peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
Oh.
May God, the Father of mercies, dwell in this house of prayer. May the grace of the Holy Spirit cleanse us, for we are the temples of his presence forever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty ever-living God, pour out your grace upon this place and extend the gift of your help to all who call upon you, that the power of your word and of the sacraments may strengthen here the hearts of all the faithful. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, O God, who through your Son, the mediator of the New Testament, graciously accept our praise and generously bestow your gifts on us. Grant that this lectionary, set aside for the proclamation of your divinely inspired word, may be a sign of our reverence for you and a help to our faithful service. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the word of God always be heard in this place as it unfolds the mystery of Christ before you and achieves your salvation in the church.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. Ezra, the priest, brought the law before the assembly, consisting of men, women, and children old enough to understand. This was the first day of the seventh month. On the square before the water gate, in the presence of the men and women, and the children old enough to understand, he read from the book from early morning till noon. All the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Ezra, the scribe, stood on a wooden desk, erected for the purpose, in full view of all the people. Since he stood higher than all the people, Ezra opened the book. And when he opened it, all the people stood up. Then Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people raised their hands and answered, "Amen, Amen." Then they bowed down and faced to the ground, prostrate themselves before the Lord. And Ezra read from the law of God, translating and giving the sense so that the people understood what was read. Then Nehemiah, his excellency, and Ezra, priest, and scribe, and the Levites who were instructing the people, said to all the people, "This day is sacred to the Lord your God. Do not be mournful. Do not weep." For the people were all in tears as they listened to the words of the law. He then said, "Go, eat the fat, drink the sweet wine, and send a portion to the man who has nothing prepared ready. For this day is sacred to our Lord. Do not be sad. The joy of the Lord is your stronghold." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Jesus Christ is the living stone, rejected by men, but chosen by God and precious to him. Set yourselves close to him, so that you too, the holy priesthood that offers the spiritual sacrifices which Jesus Christ has made acceptable to God, may be living stones, making a spiritual house. As Scripture says, "See how I lay in Zion a precious cornerstone that I have chosen, and the man who rests his trust on it will not be disappointed." That means that for you who are believers, it is precious. But for unbelievers, the stone rejected by the builders has proved to be the keystone, a stone to stumble over, a rock to bring men down. They stumble over it because they do not believe in the word. It was the fate in store for them. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a consecrated nation, a people set apart to sing the praises of God who called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
According to Luke.
Mary
set out and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? From the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exalts in God my Saviour, because he has looked upon his lowly handmaid. Yes, from this day forward, all generations will call me blessed, for the Almighty has done great things for me.
Holy is his name, and his mercy reaches from age to age for those who fear him. He has shown the power of his arm. He has routed the proud of heart. He has pulled down princes from their thrones and exalted the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, the rich sent empty away. He has come to the help of Israel his servant, mindful of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, of his mercy to Abraham and to his descendants forever. Mary stayed with Elizabeth about 3 months and then went back home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the gospel that we have just heard, we are told that Mary went in great haste to visit Elizabeth. Well, whatever about Mary and her great haste, this church that we dedicate tonight was not built in great haste. What we do here tonight is the culmination of a very long journey, many seats set out and many seats packed up. How many sausages, I don't dare to guess. So it has been a long and winding road. And this building, in all its beauty, and the beauty will become still more dazzling once the mosaics are in place, this building is the work of blood, sweat, and tears. In many ways, it is the blood, sweat, and tears of this faith community congealed into a great building here in Springfield. So in that sense, it is a building that is founded not just upon the earth, but upon the blood, sweat and tears of human beings, like Father Mauro Conte, but also the people who are entrusted to his pastoral care. It's also cost a lot of money. Not just the parish's money, but even the archdiocese's money. So I have literally a vested interest in this church. So that again you could say it's founded upon the treasure, the hard-won treasure, of the Catholic people of Springfield and the Catholic people of the Archdiocese of Brisbane, past and present. And yet all of this is in one sense true, but in another sense not true enough. Because this church that we dedicate here tonight is in fact founded upon something much more mysterious and in the end much more reliable, and that is the Word of God. Now, we have heard the story of the priest Ezra. Ezra, who reads from the Word of God from morning till evening. Now, we're not going to do that, but the point of that story is this. The people had just returned from exile in Babylon, and they had come back to Jerusalem, which was in ruin. The jackals prowled over the ruins of the city. So the task that they faced of rebuilding the holy city and the temple seemed almost hopeless. And what Ezra the priest says in reading the word of God to the people is, the foundation upon which we rebuild both the city and the temple is the word of God, not the ruins of the old Jerusalem, but the word of God is the only foundation upon which we will build something that lasts. And what was true thousands of years ago, after the return from the exile in Babylon in the 6th century BC, is no less true in Springfield in 2017. This church is founded upon the Word of God, and if it's not, it's just another building, and it will crumble into dust one way or another. Because it's a building that is founded upon the Word of God, in this building, another temple will take shape. The old cry is that people build buildings and then buildings build people. Now, we've heard from St. Peter that Jesus Christ is building us into a living temple. So what really matters is not so much the bricks and mortar, the glass and the stone and the wondrous works of art that will fill this place. That's all important enough, but none of it matters in the end if it doesn't build up a living temple, a spiritual temple of living stones, as St. Peter said in what we've heard this evening. A people who hear the word of God and who believe what they hear. And Peter says that the foundation of this living temple is in fact Jesus Christ himself, flesh and blood, one of us, he who is the Word in flesh, as much now as he ever was in the past. So that a living temple is to be built from this place and in this place, a living temple of those who hear the Word of God, the voice of Christ, and put their faith in it. There are many people who don't hear the Word, and there are those who hear the Word but can't or won't believe it. But we, the disciples of Jesus, in the church are those who hear the word and who put our faith in that word. And so we become a living shrine, a living temple made of stones of faith. So what is the word of God that we put our faith in? We've heard it on the lips of the Mother of Christ, Our Lady of the Southern Cross, in her great song of liberation that we call the Magnificat. There she sings of the God who turns everything on its head. The word of God is a bomb that subverts and overturns all the seemingly non-negotiable status quos of this world. He puts forth his arm in strength. He scatters the proud-hearted and raises the lowly. Well, this is the home for the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. Well, this is a table for the starving. You see what I mean? He overturns all the status quos in a world that says that the starving starve to death, that the lowly are trampled into the dust. This building stands as a monument at the heart of this city of Springfield to say that that is not the truth. The real truth is of a God whose word is powerful enough to overturn those status quos and even to raise the dead to new life. This is a word that is more powerful than death. The word that raised Jesus Christ from the dead is the same word upon which this building is founded. You see then why this building matters, not just for the Catholic community that will gather here. It matters for the city of Springfield and indeed for the whole Archdiocese of Brisbane. Maha Sinathambi is not with us tonight. I think Maha's daughter is with us. You are very welcome. Greet your father, who I'm told is in China. Now, Maha wanted a cathedral in Springfield. And I kept saying, well, there's one problem, Maha. You don't have a bishop. And I'm not moving to Springfield. So you can have something, but you're not going to have a cathedral. What he wanted was a big and beautiful church that would speak of the soul of the city. So this may not be a cathedral with its bishop, though Father Mauro is good. But this is a monument to something without which a city is just an empty shell. I often think of a church like this as a kind of well around which the village is built, because you can't live without water, and spiritually the human being can't live without the living waters that will flow ceaselessly from the well of this church of Our Lady of the Southern Cross. It's a well that goes so deep that it reaches into the very depths of God. And the living water that flows from this well is in fact the living water that can only come from the heart of God, which for us is the heart of Christ. So living water will come here for the thirsty, a banquet, a great feast for the starving, and the lowly will be lifted up to a place of proper dignity. When I first came to Springfield, quite some years ago now, I thought, what a dry patch of ground. And it really is. It must have been just a bit of scrub on very dry earth, because it can still look something close to the Sahara. And the irony then of calling it Springfield. It looked anything but, and I say this on the 1st of September, which is not only the Feast of Our Lady of the Southern Cross, but which is also the first day of spring. So how right it is that we dedicate this church on the first day of spring in Springfield. What this church then will do for this city is ensure in so many different ways, and again and again and again, that the dry earth, not only of the city, but of the human heart, really can become a field of springtime. And it's that vision that drives us to echo the great song of Our Lady of the Southern Cross. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit, our spirit, rejoices tonight in God our Saviour, because he takes the dry earth and he builds upon it a monument to the water that is springing up to eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Having heard the word of God, let's together give voice to the faith that makes us one. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins,
and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We gather with the whole church in heaven and on earth. So let's now ask the saints to support our prayers to God the Father Almighty, who has made the hearts of his people faithful temples of his Spirit.
Let us kneel.
Ora pro nobis.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
From all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
From every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
From everlasting death.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your incarnation.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your death and resurrection.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
Be merciful to us sinners.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Govern and protect your holy church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Keep the Pope and all the ordained in faithful service to your church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring all people together in peace and true harmony.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Comfort with your mercy the troubled and afflicted.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Strengthen all of us and keep us in your holy service.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Make this church holy and consecrate it to your worship.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of the Southern Cross, and of all the saints, make our prayers acceptable to you. May this building, which where Christians gathered in fellowship, may worship you in spirit and in truth, and grow together in love. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us stand.
Saint Anthony of Padua. Saint Thérèse of Lisieux. Blessed John Baptist Scalabrini.
Thank you.
Father in heaven, source of all holiness and true purpose, it is right that we praise and glorify your name. For today we come before you to dedicate to your lasting service this house of prayer, this temple of worship, this home in which we are nourished by your word and by your sacraments. Here is reflected the mystery of the Church. The Church is fruitful, made holy by the blood of Christ, a bride made radiant with his glory, a virgin splendid in the wholeness of her faith, a mother blessed through the power of the Spirit. The Church is holy, your chosen vineyard. Its branches envelop the world. Its tendrils, carried on the tree of the cross, reach up to the kingdom of heaven. The Church is favored, the dwelling place of God on earth, a temple built of living stones, founded on the apostles, with Jesus Christ its cornerstone. The Church is exalted, a city set on a mountain, a beacon to the whole world, bright with the glory of the Lamb and echoing the prayers of her saints. Lord God, send your Spirit from heaven to make this church an ever holy place and this altar a table ready for the sacrifice of Christ. Here may the waters of baptism overwhelm the shame of sin. Here may your people die to sin and live again through grace as your children. Here may your children, gathered around your altar, celebrate the memorial of the Paschal Lamb and be fed at the table of Christ's word and Christ's body. Here may prayer, the church's banquet, resound through heaven and earth as a plea for the world's salvation. Here may the poor find justice, the victims of oppression true freedom. From here may the whole world, clothed in the dignity of the children of God, enter with gladness your city of peace, the new and eternal Jerusalem. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. We anoint this altar and this building. May God in his power make them holy, visible signs of the mystery of Christ and his church.
Ascend as incense in your sight. As this building is filled with fragrance, so may your church fill the world with the fragrance of Christ. Amen. Thank you. Light of Christ, shine forth in the Church and bring all nations to the fullness of truth.
Thank you. will feed your spirit with faith and fullness of life. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and for the good of his holy church.
May the gifts of your joyful church be acceptable to you, O Lord, so that your people gathering in this holy house may come through these mysteries to everlasting life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. For you have made the whole world a temple of your glory, that your name might everywhere be extolled. Yet you allow us to consecrate to you places like this for the divine mysteries. And so we joyfully dedicate to your majesty this house of prayer built by human hands. Here is foreshadowed the mystery of the true temple. Here is prefigured the heavenly Jerusalem. For you made the body of your Son, born of the tender virgin, the temple consecrated to you, in which the fullness of the Godhead might dwell. You also established the church as a holy city, built upon the foundation of the apostles, with Christ Jesus himself the chief cornerstone, a city to be built of chosen stones, given life by the Spirit, and bonded by charity, where for endless ages you will be all in all, and the light of Christ will shine undimmed forever. Through him, O Lord, with all the angels and saints, we now give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francesco, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop here present, the order of bishops and all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to our prayers, the prayers of this family, who dedicate this church to you. May it be for your family a house of salvation and a place for celebration of your heavenly sacraments. May the gospel of peace resound and the sacred mysteries be celebrated, so that your faithful, formed by word of life and divine grace on their pilgrim way through the earthly city, may merit to reach eternal Jerusalem. There, in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Sacrifice becomes the table of the feast. Let's gather all our prayer into the prayer which the Lord has taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Mauro, soprattutto grazie a te. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
We're about to approach the altar to receive the body and blood of Christ. Ushers are stationed around the church to assist. Please wait to be guided by an usher to receive communion.
Spirit and grace, here in this meeting. song you gave us, the way that you laid down your life, your spouse you have made us. We, the church, long to be one with you.
Jesus, this is your blood, out of
Let us pray. Through these holy gifts we have received, O Lord, we pray, instill in our minds an increase of your truth, so that we may constantly adore you in your holy temple and glory in your sight with all the saints. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'll fall on you, Jesus.
us pray. Lord and Father of all holiness, from whom the true bread from heaven has come down to us, bless us, bless this Blessed Sacrament Chapel and the tabernacle we have prepared. Through our adoration of your Son present in the Eucharist, lead us to a closer union with the mystery of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. acknowledge your infinite glory and the great abundance of your gifts. Before the foundation of the world, you appointed Christ the beginning and ending of all things. You chose the Blessed Virgin Mary as the mother
and companion of your Son, the image and model of your Church, the mother and advocate of us all.
She is the new Eve through whom you restored what the first Eve had lost. She is the daughter of Zion, who echoed in her heart the longings of the patriarchs and the hopes of Israel.
She is the poor and lowly servant who trusted solely in her Lord.
In the fullness of time she was delivered of the Son of Justice, the day spring from on high, your Son, Jesus Christ.
In her flesh she was his mother, in her person his disciple, in her love his servant.
Father, may your children who have provided this image of Mary, Our Lady of the Southern Cross, know her protection and trace in their hearts the pattern of her holiness. Bless them with faith and hope, love and humility. Bless them with strength in hardship and self-respect in poverty. Bless them with patience in adversity and kind-heartedness in times of plenty. May they search for peace, strive for justice, and realize your love as they pursue their journey through life towards your heavenly city, where the Blessed Virgin Mary intercedes as Mother and reigns as Queen. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Listen to the parish priest without whom none of this would have happened. Father Mauro.
Your Grace, brothers in ministry, distinguished guests, dear parishioners, it is with great joy that I address you on this wonderful occasion of the opening and dedication of our new church, Our Lady of the Southern Cross, a joyful event, not just for our parish, but for the whole archdiocese. When 7 years ago, Archbishop Battersby appointed me parish priest to this new area in Springfield, little did I know about the journey that lay ahead of me. I was excited, I was happy, because everything and everybody was new. And then there was the project of building a new church. I guess not all priests get the opportunity to build a church, but I was given that privilege, and with the help and support of many, I've tried to deliver the best I possibly could. I had both difficult and exciting times, challenges, failures, and victories, moments where I was absolutely stubborn to get what I wanted. A lot of people say this building an Italian church. Everything is from Italy. But there were also moments where I gave in. It has been amazing. But this is not the opportunity I'm thankful for. What I treasure most is the opportunity I was given to start a new parish community. And tonight, I thank God, His grace, and the people from the Archdiocese who have continued to support us. Today, hundreds of people from Springfield can call this place home. And today is neither the beginning nor the end of our journey. We will continue to make it happen together. A lot of people have worked on our church, some of them in the design and others in the building. A lot of them parishioners. You all have been working very hard and with love so that our church and this solemn liturgy tonight could become a memorable day. And I'm grateful to you. Our parish is very appreciative of St. Augustine College and of Lyon and his staff for generously donating their facilities, sharing their facilities. Not yet? For sharing their facilities with us for the last 7 years. I look forward to continue our sharing, our relationship between the college and the parish. And we have now moved closer to Good Shepherd Primary School, and Judith and staff will see more of us. The church is not finished yet. There are still 150 square meters of mosaic to be put in place, representing different scenes from the Old and New Testament. When they are ready, hopefully Christmas, the mosaic... Why are you laughing? It's going to happen. The mosaics will replace the fabrics that you see hanging from the walls behind me, and we will be able to auction all that fabrics. They are behind me in the Blessed Sacrament Chapel, in the near to the baptismal font, and outside above the entry door. I'm very thankful to the many donors and benefactors who have generously donated time, money, and items that have now become part of our church. I want our generous donors to know that you are, for us, a constant reminder of God's generosity to His people, and that we will always keep you in our prayers. Some of you are not even parishioners, and yet you have been so generous to us. I have been very biblical in my approach. Ask and you shall receive. Knock and the door will be opened to you. I have knocked many doors. And many of those doors have opened. And from the bottom of my heart, I sincerely thank you, all of you. There are too many of you to mention, and your names have been acknowledged in different plaques. But it would be remiss of me not to mention at least one name. And I know that my parishioners would fully agree with me. I'm talking about Vim Balachandran. The chairperson of the church building committee. Vim has given hundreds and hundreds of hours together with his expertise and passion. He has been a wonderful helper and a great companion in this journey. Thank you, Vim, for your dedication and also for being very patient with me. Vim is not here tonight. He's in bed with fever, but he's watching us. Thank you, Vim. And I know you're crying right now. What comes next is in God's hands, and our success in our mission will be determined on how much we allow Him to work in and through us. I know this parish is determined to walk the path of discipleship. Many have been praying on this for this occasion and the building at large. We want to thank God for all that has been achieved. As we dedicate this church to God, we come to you, Mary, our mother, that through your intercession and guidance, you may continue to do the work God calls us to do. Let his love be with us as we enjoy the blessings of the Lord always. Then all the people said amen and praised the Lord. I'd like to conclude to give a gift to Archbishop Mark Coleridge as a sincere thanks and gesture of our appreciation. It is made from the same German beech wood as our pews, and it is embossed with the Archbishop's coat of arms. Thank you sincerely, Your Grace, and keep us in your prayers.
In this diocese or any other diocese that I know who could have done quite the job that Father Marco Conte has done, not only in building this church but in building this community. He's a man of remarkable gifts, and those gifts are seen in the church but even more so in the community of faith, hope and love that is well and truly part of the life of Springfield. So here tonight I just want to say what a magnificent job Mauro Conte has done in 7 years, and the magnificence is seen in the beauty and power of this church that we have dedicated. So Mauro, thank you. Here tonight, Mauro, Mother Filomena.
Thanks be to God.